One of the interesting changes we've seen in fencing is how the equipment or the clothing has changed, and with the advent of modern materials, which are lighter, more breathable, it certainly assists fencers. And at the same time, fencing has got faster, more athletic, and it's very helpful to have these modern wicking materials that take sweat away, help chill you down a bit when you're fencing. Here's an original mask from about 1905, which has no bib. It's all handmade. This is leather, which is hand sewn. By the 1930s, we end up with a mask we made in Covent Garden. It's cloth hand sewn on. We now have a bib, and this is starting to help protect just under the neck and round the neck. Now we come to a modern mask which is made of stainless steel. The great advantage of this particular mask is that all the elements can be removed. By about 1910, they were starting to do training in sows with swords which are non-sharp. So they don't have a point, they have a little button on, metal button, and probably they were round with a cloth or some tape to make them protective. And this is an epee, lightweight alloy guard, relatively new invention of us, of a lightweight blade. Inside, see-through pad so you can see where the wires are, lightweight components and plastic injection mouldings. Nowadays, of course, all the fencing is judged electronically, and this allows much faster movements, which basically judges couldn't see in the old days. The biggest change has been the refereeing is assisted by video replay. If there's any doubt in the decision of the referee, the fencer appeals and says, can you have a look at the video replay? They have to go and have a look at it, and with another assessor referee, decide whether the decision and the hit is correct or has to be reversed. Fencing is best staged on a raised podium, and therefore the fencer is actually showcased on a piece which is 1.5 to 2 meters wide and 18 meters long. This puts a fencer up in the air as the center point of what's going on. You can make it very slightly springy, so the fencer can move faster and better on it, and it encourages a more attacking style of fencing. And under the piece, you can actually put lights which help visualize when hits are scored for the actual audience. For the Olympics, there was something like 5 kilometers of cabling, 250,000 LEDs, and I must say, it did look good.